Hi, I'm Ben from Moco Toolbox. If you are planning to use motion control in your production, whether it's for video or making stop motion, there are a few components that are essential for any motion control system. Let's see what those components are and what devices, rigs, or parts you're going to need to run a motion control system. Let's say we have a camera or an object that we want to be moved by the power of an electric device. We are going to need something that can convert electrical signals into physical motion. That device would usually be an electric motor. But for technical reasons, we can't use regular motors like those that are used in a hairdryer or a toy car. We use some sort of specific electric motor called a stepper motor. These motors are built in a way that we can tell them precisely how far, in what speed, and what direction to move. This motor would be the first component of a motion control system, which we call an actuator. The next component of the system would be a stepper motor driver. What is a driver? A stepper motor can't be directly connected to a power supply, like what you do with a regular DC motor. They need some sort of more complicated electric signals, and they have 4 to 5 wires depending on the type. So the stepper motor driver gets the power from a power supply and generates those electric signals that the motor needs to run. So far in our system, the stepper motor is like a muscle. It can move things. And the driver is like the blood. It provides energy for the muscle to move. Now the question is, how should this movement be? At what speed or what direction should this motor move? In the muscle and blood example, it's the brain that controls the movement. Same here. Our system needs a brain. The next part of our system would be the controller. The controller is the brain of our system. It provides the controlling signals for the motor driver so the driver knows how to apply the energy to the motor. The controller can be a computer, like a laptop, and a software, like DragonFrame. Or it can be a small, integrated, compact circuit called a microcontroller. If we use a computer and a software like DragonFrame as the controller of the system, we are going to need an additional device too. Why? Because the most common way that a computer talks to the outside world these days is via a USB port. And the thing is, motor drivers cannot understand the language of a USB port. The signals that are coming through a USB port needs to be translated into some sort of signals that are understandable for the motor driver. So we need an interface device to translate those signals for the driver. That's why if you are using DragonFrame for motion control, you are going to need to program an Arduino or by the DMC32 from DragonFrame as the interface to be able to talk to the driver and eventually run the motor. If you're buying a commercially made camera slider, you probably won't need to connect it to a computer because there is a small computer inside which is programmed in a way that it can talk directly to the motor drivers, which are again part of that device. And the last component of the system would be the mechanics. The motor shaft rotates and it can rotate things. But even if we want the rotational movement, we need some sort of attachment to the motor shaft to manipulate that movement in a way that we want. Do we want a turntable? We want a tilt pan camera head that can rotate the camera in different directions, or whatever we need. We need some sort of mechanics to attach to the motor so we can have different qualities of movement. Plus, for a lot of purposes, we need linear movement rather than rotational movement. We want to be able to move something from point A to point B in a linear way. So we need some sort of mechanical solution to convert the rotational movement of the motor into whatever movement we need. Here is a completed diagram or anatomy of a motion control system. We can add a lot to it. We can add feedback systems. We can use more advanced motors. We can use servo motors. But these are the basic essential components to run a motion control system for your video or stop motion production. Please hit the like button if you like the video and subscribe to the channel if you like to learn more about the motion control devices that I make and if you like to know how you can make your own DIY motion control devices and taking your production to the next level. Thank you.